Hello everyone, myself Sumit. I am going to start MATLAB tutorials for beginners. First of all, I will introduce about the MATLAB. It was first released in 1984. MATLAB stands for Matrix Laboratory. MATLAB is a multi-paradigm numerical computing environment and programming language, which was developed by MathWorks. So what are the main important features of MATLAB? MATLAB allows matrix manipulations. We can plot many functions and our data. We can also write the codes of our choice. We can do implementations of algorithms. So this is written in C/C++ or MATLAB. We can install MATLAB in Windows, Mac OS and Linux operating system. If you want to know how to install or download this MATLAB, you can ask me or comment me. As of 2020, MATLAB has more than 4 million users worldwide. We have MATLAB R2019A. Here R means release, then there is a year 2019, then there is a letter A, so that R2019A means it is released in 2019, and A means it is the first release in that year. And if it is written like R2019B, then it means it is the second release of that year. Now I will tell you about the MATLAB interface. This is command window. We can enter MATLAB functions or code here. This is called command window prompt. This is our workspace. It gives you the input output details of the MATLAB function you run. The command history maintains a record of the MATLAB function you run. So this is your current folder. This will give you the idea about the directory where you can save or export your data. Now we are going to start with MATLAB. In first video, I will explain MATLAB basics. Two arrows defining the MATLAB prompt where the commands are entered. We can type any variables or input values in command window. Let us see addition of two numbers. 4 plus 7. So it gives you the answer 11. Now we can see this MATLAB is working. Now we can look for multiplication. 7 into 9. So give you the result. This is the workspace where we can see the last answer, 63. Also we can see command history, whatever we typed in the command window. Let us start with something simple like defining a row vector. Now we define any variable x equal sign brackets, give any number of your choice, 7 space 8 space 1 space 9 space 41, and then bracket. If we do enter, so we can see this is your matrix. Note that we use the equal sign for assigning the variable name x to the vector. We use brackets to enclose its entries and spaces to separate them. Also, we can use कॉमाज इंस्टेड ऑफ स्पेसेस टू सेपरेट द एंट्रीज और इवन ए कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ द टू. लेट अस सी हियर. एक्स इक्वल टू ब्रैकेट 14 कॉमा 15 कॉमा 2 कॉमा 9 ब्रैकेट क्लोज एंड देन एंटर. और वी कैन सी द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ बोथ. एक्स इज इक्वल टू ब्रैकेट 14 कॉमा स्पेस 15 कॉमा स्पेस 2 कॉमा स्पेस 9 कॉमा स्पेस ब्रैकेट क्लोज एंड देन एंटर. सो वी कैन गेट आवर रो वेक्टर्स हियर. यूज ऑफ कॉमाज और स्पेसेस आर इसेंशियल. नाउ वी विल लुक फॉर ए कॉलम वेक्टर. मीन्स हाउ वी कैन क्रिएट ए कॉलम वेक्टर. सो वी हैव टू मैथड. फर्स्ट वी कैन डिफाइन ए रो वेक्टर एंड टेक इट्स transpose to obtain the column vector. So let us see here. Suppose we can define any variable by equal to bracket 1 space 4 space 8 space 9 space 10. So this is variable y, and we can see this is a row matrix. If we entered here, so we get the row matrix. Suppose if we want to column matrix, then we can take its transpose. So for that we use the single quote. So y single quote and then enter. So here you can see this row matrix converted to your column matrix. That means we have taken the transpose of row matrix. We can use semicolons to separate the entries and we can get the column vector. Suppose we can define a variable z equal to bracket 78 semicolon 12 semicolon 10 semicolon 25 bracket close and then enter. So we can get the column matrix here. Here fonts are very small. If we want to increase the font size, then we can go in preferences. So we can see here fonts. We can increase the font size here. Suppose we can do 18, apply, OK. Sometimes we might not wish to see the output of a specific command. So we can suppress the output by using a semicolon at the end of the command line. Suppose we have any variable z equal to bracket 74 semicolon 45 semicolon 12 2 bracket closed. So if we put semicolon here, then it will not give you the output. Enter. So here you can see. Then again, if you type z and then enter, then it will give you the your final output. So it is giving you the column matrix. Now we will see what variables we define and occupy our workspace type in command window. For this we can type one command, whose, WHOS, and then enter. So this will give you the all information about your workspace. So we define three variables x, y, z. Their sizes are given here. Widths are used for this matrix. A similar command called WHO, WHO, enter. So this command give you the variables of your workspace. Suppose if you want to erase any variable from the memory, then we can use the command clear. Clear X. So I want to erase variable X from the memory, then enter. If I again type X here, then it is showing the undefined function or variable X. That means this clear command erase the variable X from this memory. We can save this file by using save workspace. So I am going to save at the desktop location. I can give the name for this file. Suppose it is test file. Always remember the data workspace extension is .mat, .mat file. Save is here. Suppose if we want to clear this command window, we can use from clear command window, or we can type here clc. Also we can erase or we can clear from here, clear workspace, also clear command history. This is the test file which we saved earlier. We can again load this file, load space, enter the file name. So this is your file name, test file. Test file dot mat. Enter. So this is showing the error because we have not defined the path for our file. For this, first we define the path of this file. So we can browse for folder. We choose desktop here, select folder. So now we can see this input or output data file is here in your current folder. Now we can load here, load test file dot mat, enter. So we can see here workspace is giving your two variables y and z. Now we can have a look at this y, enter. So it is give you the your row matrix. Now in the end of this video, we will learn about the help command. It provides you any existing MATLAB command. Let us try for WHO command, WHO. So help WHO and then enter. So it is going to give you all information about WHO command. So WHO list current variables gives you the information about current variables. So we can see lot of information are available here. Also we can use from here, help. This is your MATLAB documentation. Type here WHO and then enter. So you can also see the information about your commands. Thank you everyone for watching this video.